And next, we will talk about the calculations improvement and about the minimum two hanger necks. Last, we will take a look at the run-out extended tool paths, which are often used for some precise machining. Okay, these the options for today's topic. So let's go to see the details about each of them. The first one is the clear layout for the parameter form. Now in the screen, what we have shown you is the new screen parameter inputting certain format. About the detail information, I would like to show the details in our software. So I will switch to the ZW3D. Okay, now we are in the new version of ZW3D 2014. Okay, in here, let's take a look first. Take a look at the parameter form. This is the first one thing we would like to introduce. From this parameter 13 form, you have found that all the information has been integrated in a reasonable and clear way. In order to make user understand easily and user friendly. From here you will find everything you will like, if you want. Like the parameter information, like the frame and the speed, and then you need to set up your tolerance and rest the material sink, and also the cutting steps and step time. All the necessary information has been integrated in the primary, and then user normal like to set some limiting condition to help them to get a clear tool path and so on. Later, then we want to determine which kind of path model it should be. And then you need to set up your link and need out something like that. Here, display, and also for some other options like the path pattern and the feed control and more settings you can find in the advanced options. Those options have been integrated under this tab, because those options not used very often, for some normal user, So, this is a big point for this version's CAM, we can say it has a clear workflow and more easy, user-friendly interface when user use it, Okay, another tips I would like to tell you is that when you go to Setup Manager, you will find that actually you can get all those options, but sometimes maybe you don't want to see some of them because not everybody wants to use all of them, so you can go to Setup, you right click your mouse, and then you can get certain. Then it will pump up a campaign manager display setting. You can determine which one to display and which one to hide. Okay, like here, if I don't want to use the multiple frame to meaning, or that I don't want to use the indexing, so you have no need to use frame. So you don't need to set up it. Just use the default one. That's something like that. Okay. Now, which one you don't want to show, you can very easily to check it or uncheck it in here. If I want to show the tools, which tool has been used and which tool refers to operation, you want to see here, you can find all of them. Under each tool, you will find those information to remind you which operation has been used with this tool. Okay, this is the first point about the workflow. The second one is that is some functionalities improvement. It's about some tool paths order, or the maybe we can say in the region priority rulers. Okay, here we list the difference between the 2013 and the 2014. From the picture in the left side, we found in the above, we will find all the tour paths from the 2013, 2 months lead in and lead out, because the cutting will not carry out strictly according to the region priority ruler, so that it costs a lot of tour paths, air cut and so on. The picture below is the new result from the latest version. You will find that it's more clear and more smooth. Yeah, no, not less air cut in there, and it will help you to save your time, and it will implemented according to the region priority rule. Okay, about this point, I would like to go to software and use this example to show you how, where is the difference. Yeah, actually this is the old tour pass we imported from the older version of ZWCV 2013. From this you can find just like what we have said. Yeah, a lot of air cut and a lot of jam lead in, lead out. Yeah, it's not what we want. So I will duplicate a new operation to do that with the same parameter. Okay, use this one. I will duplicate it and then use the same parameter. I will not change anything and just calculate. After calculation, you will find a different tour path will create. And the new tour path is more clear and smooth and efficient. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Let's go to solid verify it. Yeah, it will show you this process will strictly according to the region priority ruler. Yeah, like this. Mm-hmm. Okay, and let's take this and then down to show it. Now, yeah, you get a new one, like this one. Yeah, you change it. Okay, and then let's use the solid verification to show it. Let's slow down this one. Yeah, it's working very well. Yeah, it cut all the regions according to the ruler of region priority ruler. Yeah. Okay, let's speed up this. Yeah, to see the result. Okay, and this is the first example to show this one. Actually, we also have another example. Want to show, use this one to show this point. Yeah, actually, now we also get some older to pass from the older version of ZWCV. Now let's first take a look at the solid verification about the sequence, how this tour pass cover these materials. Yeah, you will find that, yeah, the sequence is not so good. Yeah. Our mirror slip. Yeah. It doesn't cut this material according to the region first the ruler. Yeah, like this. So let me take it. Let's just duplicate it. And then first hide it, and then calculate again. Now we get a new one, and then I want to use the solid verification to show the sequence about of it. Now you will find In this process, it will first machine one region and then jump to another region. Yeah, it's different with the previous one. One by one, yeah. In this way, it can help user to saving the machine time. Yeah. Okay, this is the result. But for most of the time, if we want to cut this kind of part with the same wall with it, so what we want to do, actually we want to, maybe we want to order the cutting sequence. Maybe we want to first cut in this region and then another go to here because we want to keep the region of it. And then go to here, and then go to here. Next, I will combine the toolpath editor to show how to use the new toolpath editor to get this kind of sequence. Yeah, actually, this reorder function can help us to do that. So, let's first look at another important point: new toolpath editor. In this point, I would like to show you some new function about the path editor. Yeah, just like this picture show you, you find that actually we have developed a series tool to help user to trim and move pattern and middle and scale and reorder within also extend the tool path. Okay, the same, let's go to the software to see how to use the tool path editor work. Now here we got a disorder tool path for the rest the roughing operation. But in this phrase, we are not happy with the toolpath yet. So we need to edit it. How to edit it? I would like to use the toolpath editor. I first use the trim because I want to trim some unnecessary toolpaths above this growth. Okay, let's do that. Yeah, first highlight it. Yeah, it's this one and then trim, and then you can see it's like one option to do that. Use the polygon line to pick it. In order to get a clear idea about where I want to choose, I will first hide this part. Just left the toolpath in the blank area. Okay, then let's align our view in the top view. Yeah, and then let's go to move. Just like you draw a box, and then all the toolpaths within the within this box will be trimmed. Go to here, go to here, and double click your middle mouse. Wow, amazing! Yeah, quickly get rid of the unnecessary toolpaths to help you to get a clear and smooth toolpath. Also, you can keep on going on this region. Okay, we do that. Oh, good. Yeah, the world is clear. Yeah, you can find the toolpath is clear and smooth. Yeah, no unnecessary toolpath on it. Yeah, it's safe. Yeah, okay. Also, you will find the link in and link out between the toolpaths also has been automatically updated. Yeah, this another amazing point about the toolpath editor. It will help you to automatically do that. Okay, just say okay. Then let's carry out a solid verification. Verification, you can do that. Mm-hmm. Now you can find it. You just move around this region. Yeah, just now we have mentioned how to use the toolpath editor to reorder our cutting sequence. Yeah, it's very easy. Use this reorder operation to do that. So let's back to the previous example to see how to do that. First, let me highlight it. And also, align the view to the top view and highlight it. And then use the with order. And I want to first cut this one. Oh, it's okay. So I pick this and then make it into the bottom of the sequence. And then I will go to this one and pick this and go to the bottom again. And yeah, you can pick one, another one where you want to cut in the next time. And then keep on going and then pick this one. And pick this one, yeah, go to the bottom, and go to the bottom, okay, now, go to bottom, okay, now, go to bottom, again, okay, now, the sequence of the machining has been changed. Now let's go to verify edge to see whether it's okay. Okay, let's take a look at it. Solve the verification and let's slow down this process. The first cut this region and then jump to this here. By this way, it can help user to keep the rigid of this part. Okay. Now, yeah, next one, the third is this pocket. And the fourth one should be here. Yeah, this is how to use the toolpath editor to reorder the cutting sequence. Okay, let's speed up this process. Now, in this one. And then go to the middle, yeah. Also, from this process, you will find that the operation is very easy, just like if you know how to operate your mouse, you know how to operate GW3D scan, yeah, also. Yeah, just pick what you don't want and what you want, yeah. Just something simple like this one. Okay. Well, this is something about two new two-pass edge. Okay, yeah. Yeah, this the optimized cutting sequence with the new two-pass edge. Next one, let's go to see another example for the two-pass edge. Yeah, actually, we will use this example to show how to use those operations like the move pattern and mirror and revealing and extend, something like that. Okay, let's first highlight one two-pass. But you found the two-pass it's not what you want. Actually, maybe you want the alternative cutting sequence. So it's easy. Just highlight it. Go to reorder it. And then you will find some icon or button in here. You can change this sequence into this one. Yeah, you will find the two-pass will cut those area with the alternative sequence, yeah, like this. And sometimes maybe you are not satisfied with the two pass because it's too short. It's too short to cut all the face of it. So let's use this one. Mm-hmm. First highlight. You can extend all of them now. In order to get a full machining, yeah, okay, again, give a big value, use this. Now you get it. Yeah, okay. Yeah, this is something about the new two-pass editors, relink and reorder and extend. Okay, about the relink, I would like to use another example to show it. Okay, about here, maybe you don't want to cut this part with such a two-pass, so I will first use the trim. Okay, first. I cut edge. Now, I get this kind of LinkedIn and Meetup. So, I want to link them. Use this. And just that. It's not good, so you can change. It looks not good. Okay, you can keep on going. Yeah, you get the orange mark. Very easy to undo and redo like something like that. And you can really edge. Stripe, change the distance between them, something like that. Amazing, yeah, pretty. You can repair the destroyed trail pass like this. Okay, this about the relink function, how to use it to help you to count the unnecessary trail pass and relink them. Okay. Now here, let's take a look at this, the multiple step down operation. Yeah, okay, let's go to another example. Now in this example, for sometimes, maybe for the pockets, we cannot cut them with only one dips. We need to use different cutting dips to help us to get a good machine quality. So in here, actually we have determine define a different point to get the different step down. Okay, you can go to the boundary and limiting. Yeah, here you found for the boundary point here, you can define different boundary points to help you get the multiple step down. Then let's take a look at it. For example, I choose this point, and then add layer. Now you get a new one, and then you can go to here, and just in here, I want to use this value to cut, and add the edge, and then calculate again. Then you will find the difference will show you. Now you get a different cutting layer with a different step. Yeah, this is the big round. Use the this volume 2 mm to cut this layer. In this layer, you can use this volume and in this layer. Okay. We use different points to define different layer to get the different step down value. Okay. This simple improvement about the step down. But last improvement about the CAMS highlight is that for some precise machining case, we add a very useful tool pass extending tool pass editor function to help user to get a full machining about some precise machining. Okay. Now we take this example to show it. Now here this the default 13, yeah, we get the two pass like this one. Actually, you cannot get a full machining about the boundary, yeah, especially for along this side. You cannot get a full machining. So, if you change, go to change, boundary, And then you can change your extension Mercer. Okay. Now before we do that, we need to define extend phase. So let me duplicate a new operation to do that. And we do that again. And add create surface. This is the new surface. Mm-hmm. Let's change. Remove and okay, let's redo that again. Surface. I don't know why that doesn't work. Okay, extend. Okay, and surface. Okay, now we got it. And then, if you want to extend your toolpath, you first need to define extender surface here. Just say okay. Now you got it. And then, you can go to the parameter, find the boundary, and go to the linear where you which kind of Mercer you want to use to extend it. And also, you can give a distance for the extension calculate. Now you get a different toolpath for it. And you also can change the circular. Yeah. Okay. In this way, it's not easy to get tell the difference between the each Mercer. So I would like to copy different. And this one, let's use the circular. Okay, and change the display color. I use this one. Mm-hmm. Okay. And also, yeah, in order to get a clean idea about H, let's change this value into 10. Okay. And about this one, and let's go also, go to 10. Yeah. Now, let's change the view to this side view. Okay. Yeah, you will find this is the difference. The linear just the tangent to the surface of the circular. It means that it will allow the curvature of the extension boundary. Okay. And then last, let's go to use the last one. Use the curvature diminish. Okay. Let's get another new toolpath. Almost the same with the second one, but it's allow a curvature diminish way to get an edge. Okay. For each way you want to use, I think it should use it according to your real requirements. This is the new extended toolpath function. Yeah. Okay, for the last one, let's take a look at the minimum toolpath, minimum tool handle next. Okay. Yeah, for this one, actually we will have calculate the toolpath, and then if you go to setup and setting and check this box tools, you will find you will get this information. True or not? You get here and use the minimum total time. Okay, now you get the minimum cutting time is this one. So in order to verify the calculation result, let's duplicate it again, and I will recalculate this one to see whether this time is the same with this one. It needs a little bit of time to calculate all of them. Yeah. With this function, it can help user to get more safety cutting, yeah, because it can remind the user, yeah, the minimal hanger length should be, yeah. Actually, for today's webinar, I think, okay, now you get all the time, now you can find them, it's same. Yeah, actually, we have also get a comparison with other software, we will find them. The difference is very, very similar and very near, yeah. That's the result from the ZWCD, and this is the result from other software. Yeah, we can find almost the same. So we can say now in the native version it can provide more safety cutting for user. Yeah. Okay. I think that this is all the points I want to show off you in today's webinar about the highlights of ZW3D CAM. Okay, let's review all of these points, yeah, from the beginning. Yeah. The first one is the new workflow for parameter setting, and then is the big point for the new toolpath editor. With this new toolpath editor, you can do a lot of things to help you to get a good toolpath to finish your path. And also, the third one is the optimized roughing cutting sequence. And also, you can use the toolpath editor to optimize your cutting sequence for some special tool material, for some special part, and so on. Next one is the multiple step down in the roughing phase. You can have user to handle with the deep gray and deep pocket, something like that. And next one is for the calculation and the minimal tool hang length. It provides more convenient and safety way for user to get the safe machining. The last one is for the precise machining. You have user to extend the toolpath to get a full machine for the part phase. Okay, that's all for today's webinar. Highlights of ZW3D 2014 CAM. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Roy. So hello, do you have some question on about for today's webinar, the new CAM features in ZW3D 2014? Now, if you have any question for the CAM new features, please send your question to our email. Now, just a reminder, in next month, we will hold another webinar about the mode. So also, more information will be available later in our website, and you should be receive an email about it and soon. Now, do you have some other question about today's webinar? Now, if you have any feedback about our features, it is very highly. Okay, that's all. Now, thank you for your attending. Thank you, Roy.